Hey friends, and welcome back to my channel. My name's Jenna, and this is part two of my thrift to list process. So in part one, which I'm gonna link in the description box below, I talked about organization and how to prepare your inventory for photography. And this video is gonna show you how I photograph my items and then how I put them into inventory. Thank you so much for joining me, and let's get into the video. Okay, this is my photography setup, and I have two lights set up, and I have them aimed at 45 degrees towards the subject. So right now I'm using a clear acrylic hanger hanging on a command hook on the wall. I've also used a mannequin before, and it just depends what I am shooting. So I aim my lights, and the lights that I use are the Limo Studio softbox lights, and they're from Amazon. I'm going to link as much as I can in the description box below so you can check everything out, but they have this cover on the front, which kind of diffuses the light and helps to eliminate any shadows on the subject that you're shooting. So that is aimed there. And then right next to me, I have the clothing rack that I prepared in my last video. So this is everything I'm about to take pictures of, and I keep it as close as possible to where I am taking the photo. That way I don't have to do as many steps. So you want to try and eliminate as much work as possible and just streamline your process. And I'm going to go ahead, set you guys down and show you just how I photographed this rack. Okay, so for the last two items, I decided to use the mannequin. So the previous tank top you saw, and then this bathing suit, I just figured it would definitely look better on the mannequin. And then I have my mannequin on a Lazy Susan, so that way I can easily spin her around and take pictures as I need. So that is definitely one tip that has been very helpful. Okay, so now that all the photos have been taken, the last thing left to do is to bag and put away your inventory before you list, or at least I should say bag and put mine away, because that's what I do. I actually have a whole video on my inventory system and how I put everything away and label it. So I'm just gonna link that down in the description box below. That way I don't have to go through that spiel again. If you've already seen it, great. If not, you can check that out and see if it might be useful to you. I thought I would go through maybe some of my photography tips and tricks and just things that I've picked up throughout the years that have helped me to improve my process and definitely get faster. And one of those tips is to time yourself. So I didn't do it this time because I was filming and just had a lot going on, but typically I like to start the stopwatch and just, you know, time myself and see how long it takes me to get through a rack of clothing, because that way you'll know kind of where you can gauge yourself and see how you're doing as far as speed, Don't worry if when you start you are super slow and you get like 5 items done in an hour. We've all been there. I was super slow in the beginning, but it's nice to be able to see that improvement as you go. I also like to take all my photos on my phone, so you might have noticed that in the time lapse, but yeah, I like to take all my pictures on my phone because I like to list on my phone, so I'm able to, you know, have everything on there and not have to download it to a computer. It's just much quicker to do it that way for me. And then I also like to take all my pictures in square mode because on Poshmark, your photo has to be square. It's just optimal for mobile viewing, and instead of me trying to crop it and think about what it's gonna look like later, if I take it in square, I already know how the photo is gonna be framed. So that saves me a lot of time. And I don't really like editing, but sometimes you do have to edit photos, and I will use an app called PicTapGo. I talked about this in my monthly favorites. It is like my favorite app right now, and you can use it just for your regular photo editing, you know, solutions like brightness and contrast and saturation. However, they have some great filters, and there's one called Lights On that's my favorite filter, which just brightens up a photo, especially if you have a dark item with some details you can't see. I'll use that filter, but I will adjust it and not use it full strength. So PicTapGo is that app. I also like to take photos of the care and fabric tag. So not just the brand and size tag, but also the little fabric and care tag that's on the inside of the item normally. That is because I bag up my items and I don't want to have to reopen the bag if I don't have to. So obviously I will if there's a question that I don't know or can't answer, but for me to try and prevent people asking what's the fabric of this item or does it have to be dry cleaned, I'll just go ahead and take a picture of that and put that tag in the listing or write it in the description. But yeah, I think that's all the tips that I have as far as photos go. And the last step is just to list your items. And since I have all my photos in my phone and I have all my measurements written in a little notebook, I can list from anywhere. I prefer to list on my phone. I don't really like listing on the desktop. So what I typically like to do is go somewhere away from my house and list. So I typically will go to a coffee shop. I might go to someone else's house. I might go to a park or, you know, just sit outside. Anywhere away from my normal distractions, it lets me list a little bit faster. So hopefully some of those tips were helpful for you, and it was good to see my process as far as thrifting to listing start to finish. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button down below if you haven't already. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.